All right, Daystorm's hanging out. Daystorm,
yo yo.
How long have I don't. We don't do dinner every day, you know. Which no. You should invite me to dinner, by the way.
I will now that I have a house.
You have a house.
Yep.
I got some questions about that.
Yeah.
But you know, I've known you for a little while.
Yes.
There's a couple things.
A long while.
Yeah. A couple things I didn't know about you.
Okay.
This one thing, by the way, if you don't follow Daystorm, you should. He is one of the funniest dudes, and I'll say this about you, and I'll give the same compliment to Batch. If a network is not giving you a sitcom, they are missing out. Like, they should be lining up to give you a sitcom. Is there anything in the works like that, or do you see that happening down the road?
I think for Batch, he's working on things like that. That's not really what I want. I think
even if it's not what you want, they should come at you because you're funny.
Yeah. The networks have reached out. I just, you know, I tell them I'm editing sometimes, so I be busy.
Well, it must be nice to reject a couple of networks. It must be just a good feeling. Nah, I don't need you. My channel's bigger than yours.
No, I'm not knocking the networks. If it's something that I really want to do, like, you know, then it's like, yo, I'm trying to be down. Like, they were going to come into America, too, and I said, I got to call Leah. I called her up really quick. I said, look, this is something I want to do, you know, so you got to make sure I get a role on this. So
is that still kind of
yeah, we're working on it right now.
Oh, God. Whoever's in charge of that.
Yeah,
If you have any clue on, oh, my, don't even get me started. Yeah. All right, well, Daystorm's here. We'll talk about music because you got new music coming out, you know, soon. That's all I know. You know, we'll find out all the details. But you were a ghostwriter?
I was a ghostwriter. When I first moved to New York, I was writing for quite a few artists. I worked at four labels. I worked at Universal. I worked at J Records. I was over at Atlantic Records for a while. I was doing the music thing heavy back then, yeah.
Wait, is it, can you say, I guess you can't say, because
no.
Being a ghostwriter, you know, it's different than just being a writer because they want you to stay kind of hidden, right?
Yeah, and now that I've found my own success, I don't even care anymore. It's like, whatever, that did that. It was a door closed. It happened. Now I moved on, and I'm okay with that because back in the day, I was itching to say it. Please ask me. I want to tell somebody what I wrote. You know, but now it's these days, it's like, I don't care. But and they give writers a lot more respect. They put your name on things. Back then, it was just like, oh, so I look at my drawer, and I got, like, checks with Atlantic Records name.
And
an artist name, but not my name. I'm like, damn, that's cold, you know. So, I think writing has changed.
That's super fascinating, though. Yeah. I mean, just to, you know, and I'm sure once again you can't say, but if you told me the list, would I be like, oh my god?
A few. Some of them are not around anymore, but there's a few oh my gods in there.
All right. At one point, I was supposed to go into the studio with you, not to record, but you know, to kind of be a fly on the wall and watch you do your thing.
Yep, we can still do it.
Okay, that can still happen.
Yeah, let's do it.
You guys, yeah, Daystorm's hanging out. Follow him on everything. Add Daystorm if you're not already. Good lord, how many followers? You got so many followers. Why even push followers at this point? You know.
I don't even look, cause you know you always want to reach new people. I guess I don't know, like 9-10 million on Facebook, you know, and it's like on the gram it's like 5 million, but and then it's like you'll say see someone else, you're like, wow, I want their audience to know that I got some dope stuff for them too, you know.
Right.
So I'll push things for them as well.
Gotcha. Hey, okay, back to the music though. I want to come into the studio with you, and I want to like just sit there. Maybe you know I'll go Facebook Live or whatever. The Kiss Instagram. We'll do a live, you know.
Okay.
Or the JoJo mine. I'll do whatever.
Yep.
And I don't want to, you know, I don't want to leak any, you know, crucial stuff that needs to be held kind of top secret, you know. But I want to watch everything and then see kind of what you do because I've never seen that side of you.
No. Come through. I don't know. The creative. Everyone has their own little creative thing, you know. I don't know me. I'll just, for me, I guess I'll have a bag of popcorn and I'll be watching some random video. I get inspired by the people. I'll see something random that happens in the day, and then it's like that brings the inspiration, and I just get started, and it's like go from there. All go. All
right. And when is the new stuff? When do you think you're gonna have this stuff out?
I mean,
whenever it's done, I guess.
Whenever it's done, but I'll have something in the next 90 days. Let me just say that. Let me just give myself a.
Dude, I need to know some. You know, you got so many followers. Your fan base is crazy. Let's be honest. Give me. A crazy fan story. Give me something just wild.
All right, okay, so...
And by the way, I'm not saying all your fans are crazy.
No, they're crazy. They're crazy. That's fine. Yeah, they're crazy. They know they're crazy. It's fine. But they were... Okay, a crazy fan story. Okay, there's this one dude. He hits me up, and I guess he's living in a small town. He's like, yo, Daystorm, I really want you to put me on, dog. And I'm like, I don't know what they could do. You're like, I don't need a shout out. I just want to come to L.A., and if you bring me to L.A., you know, I don't have any money, but what I can do for you is, yo, I can share my girl with you. you know, maybe we, and it was a video, and his girlfriend's in the background just agreeing. She's like, yeah, okay, I'm down. And she's cute, you know. I'm like, but no, that's not my thing. First of all, I got a girl, you know. And second of all, it's like, yo, you wild. And he's like, no, you know. So in the video, he's saying, and she's here. He's like, baby, you know, you be with Daystone, wouldn't you? And she's like, yeah, of course. Come on, we want to come to Cali. I was like, oh, man, these people are wild. People are wild.
And do you think he was, like, if, as far as you could tell, he and she were 100% serious?
No, they were 100%. They were ready. They were ready. He's like, we'll pack our bags right now, and we'll come out to L.A. My girl's down. We can shit out, you know, you can have. I'm like, wow, this is what you have to offer, you know.
Okay, granted, you didn't do that because you're sane.
Yeah, of course I'm.
But what if you would have, that'd be just, God, how awkward and weird. And, like, this guy, they were serious. That's the most awkward, just madness.
It's madness. Right? And she was down. She was ready. She was like, you know, my baby gonna get me out of here, whatever, by any means necessary. I was like, whoa, this is a crazy couple. But I've seen some crazy stories. Fans are rabid. They do some crazy stuff. And I love my fans, so it's like, I was just like, nah, dog, it's all right. You know, y'all figure it out. It's cool.
Dude, what do we forget here? What am I forgetting?
Zeus. Yes.
You are the one of the founders, one of the owners of Zeus, right?
Yes.
God, you got your hand in everything, man.
I got my hand in everything, including the cookie jar. Let's go.
What? Tell me about Zeus.
So Zeus is a SVOD, a subscription video on demand platform. It's almost like a mini Netflix. So we're doing short form, like 15 to 30 minute videos on Zeus. We just dropped a series with Quay. Blame it on Quay. We just dropped a series with Black China. So Zeus is like super dope. The subscribers are coming in by the flocks watching all of the shows. We have about 31, 32 series on there now. So Zeus is dope, man. We're just doing very well.
You're making so much money. You're making, your pocket is crazy.
Pocket.
All
right. $5 right now. I spent that.
Sorry. Yeah. So maybe you don't. What about, look, okay. So many followers. Zeus. All this stuff. You got a series. Can we say the series?
Mm-hmm.
The Comedy Central thing. Is that a thing?
So I'm working on Comedy Central. You're getting this animated series over to Comedy Central. We've been in talks with some folks over there. So got that going on as well.
All right. All this stuff going on. Yet the one thing that has been even though you have gold, platinum records, which you've sold a ton.
Gold. I don't have a platinum.
And no platinum. You know, or diamond. Yeah. So you got gold records. But one thing that's been elusive, and the one thing that you are about to tackle. Is that song that becomes a household? It's like everybody knows, even little kids, like a little Nas X kind of vibe.
Need it.
That's
Need
the
it.
One thing you. What are we doing here?
Need it. I'm coming to you, and you're gonna be the first person I come to when
okay,
I get it.
Let's do it.
Yeah. So that's it. That's the thing. It's not about the money. It's not about the tours. It's about having that household hit, so they can be like, whoa, I know Dave Storm been doing music for a long time. Now he got that hit.
All right.
So that's the thing.
And I can come in the studio and watch you do some behind the scenes stuff.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I would love that. I would love that. All right. Daystorm, thanks for hanging out, man.
Yeah, no doubt.
At the end of every interview, fist bump to make it official. Give me a little
boom. Bang. It is.
There we go.